Hello everyone, my name is Bradley, I have a Brad taste in music, and today I'm finally going to react to an album that everybody's been wanting me to react to for the longest time, and that is I Disagree by Poppy. Now, of course, Poppy had a deluxe version of this album that came out, as well as an album that came out after this called Music to Scream To that was widely panned and hated. I definitely don't plan to listen to that. But I also very much like the I Disagree More cover, as it looks like the most creepy shit ever, but also not too creepy to actually give me nightmares. So respect the Poppy for towing that line, which is something that I'm pretty sure she does on this album. Now, I Disagree. I've heard a few songs from this. This thing is insane. I've heard basically everything else from Poppy, I think, besides her album before this. Yeah, I loved her very poppy style that she was doing for a while. And now that she switched over to this, it's very interesting and a crazy, you know, change of directions. Either way, I'm excited to give it a shot and see whether or not, you know, it's worth my time. You know, this, that, bada bing, bada boom, what do you say we go and do this? All right, let me get some water real quick. I've heard I Disagree, I'm pretty sure I've heard Blood Money, and I've heard Bite Your Own Teeth, okay? So I think that that's it. This album's 10 tracks and 35 minutes. And of course, if I've already heard the song, I'm gonna react to it anyways, because that's how bad my memory is. So, that being said, first track, Concentrate. Let's give it a shot, Poppy. Let's see where this shitstorm goes. Alright. Okay. This album's gonna be complicated. Okay, so let's first start off by explaining that the lyrics seem very literal at first, you know, look about, you know, bury me 6 feet deep and cover me in concrete and turn me into a street. I'm not sure if turning you into a street actually means anything besides turning you into an actual street. Apparently the lyrics of Concrete, according to Genius, alternate between disturbing and sweet. This part of the song fetishizes being buried alive in concrete. Wait, what? It fetishizes it? Where does it fetishize it exactly? Is it in the chewy, chewy, yummy, yummy, yummy bullshit? Now, let me just start by saying, yeah, I know what you're thinking. Bradley, why aren't you excited by this? I paid you money to fake a reaction to this shit, and that's because I expect this to be crazy. So the hard part is going to be breaking it down. Knowing Poppy and knowing this album, I expect this to be insane. So I want to figure out, you know, what exactly makes these songs so good. Okay, well, I know my problem with this music, and it's the fact that I don't get it. I don't get the purpose between switching between the two styles yet, and it might take a while to get it, but yeah, as of right now, I'm a little confused, but yeah, you know, that's something I think is gonna get ironed out. I see. Okay. This is disturbing. Okay. All right. So is this about the fact that, you know, like sweet things no longer are enough for Poppy and now she needs something like blood? And maybe that's the whole idea behind this album is like, you know, the whole sweet Poppy image is dead and she needs blood. She needs to kill. And that's why everything's becoming some rock crazy bullshit.
Yeah, I'm cool with that aesthetic and that change, so let's keep going. I'm feeling it.
Bobby! Bobby! Yes! What a weird outro, too, from the way that this song started to just go into, like, this weird, like, poppy... God damn it, I can't... I use that word, like, regularly, like, to describe something as if it's an adjective. Like, to describe... art. Is it an adjective, poppy, or is that an adverb? All right, that was Concrete. The first song here, she's talking about, you know, how she wants to be buried in concrete and how the taste of candy is not better than the taste of flesh. Love it. I'm going to give it the smiley ball. Fun way to start this album. Really insane, really mind-bending shit. I like what Poppy is doing, and I'm ready to keep moving on. Next song, I Disagree. Oh, God. The hell? Okay, I was not... You know what? I've heard this song, but really, after hearing Concrete, I was not expecting that shit. Like, actually. Good. It's so like, dude, like everything I've been reacting to lately, I can put into like a box and categorize. I am struggling with this. It is like a mix between nu metal and pop music in this way that I've just literally never heard before. And I'm just like sitting here like, okay, what am I gonna say next? I'm thinking in my head and I just hear some shit. I'm just like, wait, like this is literally not giving me any breathing room. I literally cannot focus on anything but the music. All right, let's keep going. If anyone's sitting here expecting me to criticize all the little details, it's not that I'm lazy that I'm not doing it. It's that I just, like, think that all of it adds to the aesthetic. And that's why it's rough reacting to an album like this, because I am not picky here. I don't know anything about Poppy in real life, so it's really difficult to start, like, dissecting the music and complaining about it. So it just becomes me sitting here listening and, you know, liking the music. Which is not very entertaining, but it is, it's nice, you know, to do, I guess. I gotta say, that's fascinating. One, I love the production here. I love the drums. The fact that, you know, they sound so potent. You know, there's so much like boom, 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 boom. Like it's really driving. As well as I like the whatever that instrument is, the boom, 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 boom. And then of course in this Japanese, you know, saying of "I disagree with you," according to Genius. Yeah, I like it. Well, that was a unique song. Even hearing it, like, before really does not prepare me to hear it again because there's just so much shit that goes on in that song that, honestly, hearing it again is like hearing it for the first time again. It's really intense. It goes all over the place. I think the production is, you know, it's clean. It's fresh, and I like it. She disagrees with a lot of shit that, you know, is being done to her. Of course, the first... genre description for this music is Japanese, which I don't think is, you know, I mean, is that even a genre of, like, I mean, you know, not to be, I know I'm not a raging racist or anything, but it's just awkward to have Japanese as the very first genre for this song, you know? That's not really the first thing I think of when I hear this song, truly. Yep, smiley ball, really enjoyed it. Yeah, one of my favorite songs on here, really good. Next song, Blood Money. Let's go. What do you believe? This album is so weird. I have to go through this so slowly because I am not expecting this absolute insanity that I'm getting. It's like so fucking much in so little time.
Oh, this song is about, you know, my life. Shit, this is, you know, no, I'm just, you know, I'm kidding. About, you know, the whole thing being about my life. But I do relate very much to a lot of the problems here, especially the fact that, you know, I'm just gonna cut the bullshit. I was a terrible kid, all right? I did some terrible things to some people that, from, like, second grade to 12th grade. It's mostly second grade to, like, seventh grade, but still, you know what I mean? It's like, I understand this, you know? The truth of, you know, like, you know, I don't, you know, I got those demons in the closet, so. I hear this song, and it's pretty terrifying, I will say, but I'm digging it, I'm digging it. Also, the song sounds fantastic. I think it sounds a little bit too much like I Disagree, like, a little too much, but I don't really have a problem with that. When nobody's watching, also, this industrial, like, dubsteppy, loud bullshit sounds amazing. The blend of noise here, gorgeous to my ears. Love it, can't get enough of it. Masterpiece. I actually like that so much that I'm gonna move down I Disagree in Concrete by like 1 point of whatever in my documents to give this one a motherfucking 10. Blood Money was so good. I think that was by far my favorite song. I like Disagree. I like Concrete. Okay, but I think that Blood Money really took the crown there with just how this, oh, ooh, it's so in your face, dude. It's so like confrontational, actually. Like, it's so brilliant. I love it. I loved how just like sucked into that I got, you know. It was an experience. I enjoyed it. I loved it. Shit. Really awesome. Thank you, Poppy, for that amazing track. All right, you know what I'm saying? Next track, Anything Like Me. Now, I know what you're thinking. Bradley, you're gonna hate it because it's a slow song, okay? No, I'm not. All right, shit. That's you. Now we got the first spot where I finally feel like there's something to talk about that is not positive. So I'm going to take full advantage of that and completely waste everybody's time talking about the fact that I think that this song's a little meh. Okay? I think that, you know, dog, you shouldn't be anything like me part's a little eh. But that's literally it, okay? But, you know, whatever. Billie Eilish, is that you? My question is, and this is of course a crazy conspiracy, did Poppy plan to make this album beforehand? If the answer is yes, then I find this to be an incredibly interesting transformation. If the answer is no, then I find this to be an incredibly interesting transformation. Regardless, it is fascinating to see that this is the direction that Poppy decided to go. And she's really going 100% with it, and it is, I mean, you know, even if I don't love every single thing that's happening in this song, there are parts that I love in this song better than other songs, it's still an incredibly fascinating track to listen to.
I feel
These abrupt stops are giving me a heart attack. Alright, I think I finally get it. I finally get what is going on here, and I think it's that I'm literally so used to all the music I listen to having like such smooth transitions from everything that this is just the opposite of what I come to. So it takes some adjusting to get used to these incredibly abrupt transitions, but I have a feeling that once I do, it's gonna feel a little less crazy. You know what? Also, the name of this album being I Disagree, and the fact that you shouldn't be anything like me, and the fact that everybody wants to be poppy, you know, the fact that that was a song, makes this a very interesting album, as it seems like it is a big contradiction to the exact, like, thing that she was. It's as if she's becoming her opposite, you know, everything that's happy, candy, likable, light, you know, whatever. She is literally being the exact fucking opposite of that. While also maintaining this interesting, like, side of her that's like, it's still poppy, which makes it so fascinating to listen to, because the directions in which the song swings back and forth are really just ripping at me, like tearing me apart side by side. Take it out of me. You mean the demon? Oh, you mean poppy? Like, wait, is that like actual poppy? You want poppy to get out of you? And that was Anything Like Me. Another fascinating track. I'm gonna give it a smiley ball. I thought it was gonna be really interesting. I thought that it was not the song that I wanted, but it was the song that I got and the song that I'm okay with. I enjoyed it. I thought that it was creative and really abrupt. I think that the message of the song is very clear. You shouldn't be anything like Poppy, because Poppy is problematic, you know? But there is something interesting here about, you know, Poppy's old self and her trying to get rid of it, as if it, you know, like there's a back and forth here where there's like this exorcism bullshit going on. And I can't tell if she's trying to get rid of the new Poppy or the old Poppy. Either way, it's very fun to listen to and an entertaining odyssey. So, let's just keep going. Next song, Fill the Crown. Here we go. Alright, so here's my problem with this entire album, is that something has not clicked. Something. And I've been listening to this whole thing and I've enjoyed it, but like, it feels like it is so new to me that I don't even know how to fucking interpret any like feeling out of this shit. It is so back and forth, and Poppy's really doing something here that I've never really heard anyone else do to this degree. I'm shocked. I'm kind of blown away, and I really don't know what to say about this. I mean, I kind of came in expecting this. But hearing a full album of it, I'm like, oh shit, she's really going all the way, and she's experimenting, she's having a lot of interesting sounds going throughout this, and it's never really boring. This is a bad rock song, and I wouldn't enjoy this outside of the context of this. Like, I just think that this style of rock doesn't really work for any song nowadays. It sounds like a updated, but not really Metallica song, you know what I mean? It's like, you know what I mean? Except for I don't really listen to Metallica. Yo, leave a comment if you guys want me to react to Metallica, by the way. I've been wondering that for a while. Alright, am I crazy or does this suck? Am I just delusional? I'm going back. So making it louder doesn't make it sound better. Oh, God. Wow, it's the first time I'm like, I'm not really feeling this one. I appreciate the fact that it's so different from the other tracks. I really do, because this is like a complete left turn while still stylistically trying to stick to the same thing, but I think that the sound of the song just actually ends up trailing off into something unlikable. I would say just something that hasn't aged very well, that isn't very fun to listen to for me personally. So I am struggling with this song. I mean, the lyrics are interesting, poison the children, no peace in mind, poison the family, make the children cry. It's about poison, it's about film the crown. Is it about like Hamlet? Like everybody murdering everybody to try to get power or something? I mean, I don't think that's what Hamlet was about, was it? It's been a while since I've had to do Hamlet in school, you know what I mean? Not like that, of course. I also don't get this post, the post-chorus, the fucking fill the crown, let them know we're fed bullshit. I don't understand that. I think that it sounds a little tacky. Again, I could just be insane, but whatever. Alright, so unlike Blood Money, when it got really loud, I felt like it was pleasant to listen to. It was a great point for it to get loud, but I feel like Fill the Crown here, when it gets loud, I actually am more like cringing and trying to lower it rather than letting myself get sucked into the insanity of all of it, you know? Like, I like this part. This part sounds really well, done. Love the mixing here. Now it's like the joyful side of all of it. Okay. So I guess this is where everyone doesn't die. This is the good timeline. That was Fill the Crown, and also the end of part one. Fill the Crown was a song that I probably need to listen again. But if I didn't listen again, I would probably give it a shrug. Comparatively with everything else, that being said, it is not a bad song. I just think that, it just went into some directions that I don't think landed as well as other tracks. I don't necessarily dislike it, I just think it was a little sloppy. And maybe not as, complete as it tried to be. You know what? I'm so confused. I don't even want to just like have a filler answer, 'cause I honestly don't know what the hell I just listened to. What the fuck was that? What the fuck even is this album so far? It's insane. It's insane, and I have to listen to other fucking Poppy projects, I feel like, to even get what the hell is happening here. I mean, it is nuts, but it is fascinating, and it is very entertaining, and it keeps me going regardless of not understanding everything, because I feel like there is something to understand, and that's what I want in fucking music, something to understand. Thank you, Poppy, for giving me that. Overall, it seems like this album is like the embodiment of a demon showing up and taking over your body and completely destroying your innocence. It's like, not being able to run away from the awful things you've done, this is just pure insanity, but it's very entertaining, and it's very, absurd. Yeah, I enjoy this. I think it's a fun listen so far. If I had to give it a score for the first, half of this, it would be an 8 minus out of 10, which is exactly what Fantano gave it. God damn it. You know what? Fuck Fantano, okay? I'm just kidding. I love you, Fantano. I like it, and I can't wait to hear more of it. Shout out Corgi, he edited this whole thing. Made my life so much easier. I'm suffering with a lot of stuff right now, so it means a lot. Thank you, Corgi. All right, yep, that's gonna be it for part one, and peace out. See ya.